Hello everyone. So I think you have completed your exercise. So let's start to discuss question answers. So lesson name is fiber to fabric. So 9 questions are there. So one by one we will discuss about this. So question 1 is that you must be familiar with the following nursery rhymes. Now you are in 7th standard, but here you have to just learn or discuss about the nursery rhymes. See, 2 poems are given there. The first one is Baba Black Sheep, Have You Any Wool? This is the first poem. And the next one is that Mary Had a Little Lamb Whose Fleece Was White as Snow. So 2 rhymes are there, and according to that you have to just answer the following. So first question is that which part of the black sheep have wool? Okay, so here you have to write that the body part of black sheep or body part of that sheep from where we are getting the wool. So the answer is the skin of the black sheep has fur like hair mainly at the back and abdomen known as the wool, means backside, and the stomach part is there, so where we get wool. Okay, so the answer is this. So just write the answer properly. Next question is that what is mean by white fleece of the lamb? So the answer is white hair of a lamb are also known as white fleece. Means fleece means your hair. Okay. Next question, that is question 2. So here you have to just select the correct option. The question 2 is that the silkworm is. Okay, 2 options are there, that is a caterpillar, and the second one, that is B1, is a larva. So choose the correct option. So 2 options are there. 4 options are there. The first one is only A. Second one is B. Third one, both A and B. And fourth one, neither A nor B. Means the silkworm is a caterpillar, the silkworm is a larva, the silkworm is both, or silkworm is neither A neither B. So the option, the correct option is both A and B. The silkworm is a caterpillar also and a larva also. So I hope that you have written your answer correctly. Now just come on question 3. So question 3 is that which of the following does not yield wool? Means from which animal we does not get wool, that you have to select. So the options are, first one is yak, second one is camel, third one is goat, and fourth one is woolly dog. So I hope, means I think that you know the answer very well. So the answer is woolly dog. From yak, from camel, from goat we get the wool, but from woolly dog we does not get wool. Understood the question 3? Yes. Now come on question 4. So here you have to write the definition. See, the question is that what is mean by the following terms. So when our sessions were there, so I have just told that you have to learn all the definitions very properly. See the exercise. 3 definitions are there, and here you have to write that. So first is that rearing. So rearing means bringing up, raising, and taking care of animals is known as rearing. You can also write in your own words that rearing of sheep, or rearing means to look after that animal by providing them food, shelter, and proper health care. Understood? Means you can write the rearing term in your own word also. Next term or next definition is about the shearing. So shearing means what? The removal of hair with a thin layer of a skin. So see, I have written the fleece of the sheep, means the hair of the sheep, along with a thin layer of skin is removed from its body, and this process is known as shearing. That also you can write in your own words. Don't copy as it is. Third one is sericulture. So sericulture means the rearing of silkworms to obtain silk is called sericulture. Means we are just taking care of that silkworms to get silk, and that process or that term is known as sericulture. Okay, I hope that you have written that definitions properly. Next question, that is question 5, given below is a sequence of steps in the processing of wool. Which are the missing steps? Add them. Means here you have to fill in the blanks. So first one is shearing, then dash dash, sorting, dash dash and dash dash. Means 4 processes are missing and you have to add that. So after shearing, which one is there? Yes, the scouring process is there. Then sorting already given. Next one is cleaning of burrs or removal of burrs. Next one is dyeing, and after that rolling process is there. By mistake I have written. So dyeing is there and after that you are doing rolling. Okay, see the processes, 6 processes are there: shearing, scouring, sorting, cleaning of burrs or removal of burrs, dyeing, and last one is rolling into yarn. Okay, now come on question 6, that here you have to just draw some diagram. See which diagrams are there. Question 6 is that make sketches of the 2 stages in the life history of silk moth which are directly related to the production of silk. So you can draw any 2 from this. I have given all 6 sketches are there. From that sketches you have to just draw only 2 sketches. Okay, draw only 2 sketches, don't draw all. See the male silk moth, female silk moth is there, eggs on mulberry leaves, silkworm, cocoon and cocoon with developing moth. So all 6 are important. Okay, here just that directly related to the production of silk. So best you can just draw the cocoon and cocoon with developing moth. So that 2 sketches you can draw. Okay, next is question 7, that out of the following which are the 2 terms related to the silk production. So 5 terms are given there, that is sericulture, floriculture, moriculture, apiculture and silviculture. So I think with the help of the spellings or with the help of the hint you can solve that. So first hint is that the silk production involves cultivation of mulberry leaves and rearing silkworm. So as you know that the rearing silkworm means your sericulture. Okay, so first term is your sericulture. Okay, and next one, that is the scientific name of mulberry is Morus alba, so that is known as moriculture. Understood? Yes, so 2 answers are there, that is sericulture and moriculture. Next is question 8. Here you have to just match the following, that column 1 with column 2. So column 1 is given here and answer in front of that. So first is scouring is there. So scouring means what? That is cleaning sheared skin. Okay, we are just removing the grease and all. So that process is known as scouring. Next one is mulberry leaves. So mulberry leaves is the food of silkworm. So easy, match the following is there. So you have to write that properly. Yak. Yak is a wool yielding animal. So the answer is wool yielding animal. And the cocoon. Cocoon answer is silk fibers. So I hope that you have written this match the following properly and correct. Next one is question 9. So here you have to draw this grid in your notebook, and if it is not possible, you can directly write the answers. Means without just drawing these blocks and all, you can just write that the throw washing, animal fiber, long thread like structure, and in front of that you can directly write the answer. So like that also you can do. So the answers I have given here. See, so first down is there, that down 1, 2, 3, see, down 1, 2 and 3, okay, so see, first one is through washing, we are just washing and that washing process is known as the scouring, or here only the 5 blocks are there, so I have written S-C-O-U-R, scour, means just washing, okay. Next is animal fiber. Okay, which animal fiber? 4. Yes, S-I-L-K, silk. Third one, long thread-like structure, means here. So, thread-like structure, the threads are known as fiber, correct? So, I have written here F-I-B-R-E. Understood? See, F-I-B-R-E, fiber. So, the first D is scour, second D is silk and third D is fiber. Next, that is across, that is 1A, 2A and 3A. See, 1A, 2A and 3A. So, okay, see, so 1A is that keeps warm. Now, which animal fiber is there that keeps us warm? See, O is there and L is there. So, the answer is wool. W-O-O.